Well, it's not very often that me, the loser that I am, that sits on my own playing video games, gets addicted to multiplayer games. The last time it happened to me was probably either StarCraft II, Wings of Liberty, or Tribes Ascend. But Splinter Cell has got me by the short and curlies. Oh, that's a good name for a band, isn't it? No, yeah, and I'm really, really enjoying the reason why I bought this game. Spies vs. Mercs. I'm really enjoying it. I think it's a return to form. I remember playing it on Pandora Tomorrow. I'm really enjoying it, but here they've sort of expanded on it a little bit, I do believe. Like, instead of it being a stage progression, you've just got three terminals within the map to hack. But anyway, before we mosey on. So I just realised I'm playing this in a window, and I'm wondering how that. It doesn't matter. It's just a pointless little brain fart I had then. And yeah, this is like the paladin. To me, it's a guy with a sword and shield in World of Warcraft that is overpowered. But in this game, it's an airplane, apparently. I don't really know the story. I haven't played much of it. I've played a bit. I played one level. And then there was a mission where I had to like snipe people when I got bored. So this is where I've been at. Let me just show you some stuff first. So we've got ShadowNet, which shows you all the usual stuff that's in games nowadays. Fill up bars! Hey, do you want in-game currency? Fill up some more bars! And you're just like, oh, just go away. Look, bars, yeah, stats, bars, stats. Oh, let's go here. Oh, there's a bar there. Oh, and there's a bar there. Oh, fill them up. And then you just feel like you just want to fill all these bars up. Wait, I did when I played Modern Warfare, and now I'm bored of all these bars. I just want to play a game. I just want to play a multiplayer game. I just want to go back to basics. So yeah, Spies vs. Mercs is what is it says there, competing to up to 8 players. Now there's two types of, that's me slapping my chest. Spies vs. Mercs, there's 2v2 where there's no customization, it's pretty much for newbies. Or, in my experience, if you're level 56, go in there and annihilate the newbies. I was once a newbie and I got battered by some, two level 56s, which is a cap, and got absolutely bummed, which is nice. So yeah, Spies vs. Mercs is quite—it's a unique multiplayer experience. So, four of you on one team are spies. Now that's typical Splinter Cell, Sam Fisher movement actions. Hanging off of cliff edges, stabbing people in the face, shooting them, sticky cameras, smoke grenades, and then you've got the mercenary side, which is basically Rainbow Six. It's basically this game is Splinter Cell versus Rainbow Six. You've got Rainbow Six on one side. And it's all really slow and clunky, but quite powerful. And on the other side, you've got real agile spies, yeah, but they're quite fragile. So yeah, let's... Oh no, do I want to do this? Oh no, I wonder if my... I don't know if I'm going to be talking in-game or not. Shh, be quiet. I don't like talking to other people. I get stage fright. There he is, IG Shinjo at the top there. That is Kai Nemo, aka Foreman, aka Gimli. Prove the die in the better ghost. No, I'm right, cheers. I can't beat anyone being a better ghost because ghosts don't exist. Oh, run away! I'm really paranoid whether I'm talking about it. Yeah, it doesn't matter. So, as you can see, basically what I've done there is done a Splinter Cell. I've jumped on ledges, I've stabbed people in the face, and it's all good fun. As you can see, there's A, B, and C terminals to hack, and what we need to do is hack a terminal and stay within that area. Now there are modes where you can go outside the area, and, you know, knob around and stuff like that. But for this one, the SVM Blacklist Edition, you have to stay within the zones, and when you do that, you get points. These points there, then obviously XP, and they fill your bars up, as we know. So as you can see, you've got Hacker there. He's obviously the guy hacking the terminal. I don't want to sound too patronising there, but that is, them's the facts. Oh, tits. Oh, why did I do that? Okay, so that was a bit of a stupid thing to do. And as you can see, I've got a gun. It's quite powerful, but very erratic, and it will spray everywhere. I've got EMP grenades, and I've got trophies. Now, in the loadout section, you can change and customise your spies, which is why I like the 4v4 for 4v4. Fucking hell, 4v4. I'm not even going to bother saying it again because I can't. Version of Splinter Cell, Blacklist, Spies versus Mercs. Now I've got this. I can sort of look through. I can see like techie bits in the world. And if I press RB, like every character player has a special ability that recharges over time. And as you can see, I'm tagging people with my RB button. It's sort of like a UAV. It scans people. As you can see, the red silhouettes, Left 4 Dead style, sitting there. And, you know, it picks them all up. And every time they kill those guys, I get 30 points, you know, because I assisted. And so the genius of this is that, like, you know, this mode is so agile. Like, I can run really fast. Stuff. I will die in one or two bullets. And, you know, it's kind of like the risk reward. It's like, you know, speed versus power and all that shit. I've got this one right there. The genius of this is that you, no matter what side you're on, you feel really weak, like really inferior. Like you're always scared of what's going to happen on one side, and then you're always scared of what's going to happen on the other. Got him. But when you put the two against each other, it sort of works like magic. It is a really good, fun experience. Now, the idea is to hack these three terminals. So I'm really blanking on my spaces here, because one, I'm paranoid, I'm talking to a bunch of idiots in a multiplayer game, and two, I'm trying to concentrate on a multiplayer game. So yeah. So A, B, and C, as you can see, we captured one, which was C. But now we need to go and capture B and A, which, you know, it's all good fun. Now these trophies can sort of, it's called a trophy system, I don't know why, but it can basically just like negate any gadget that a merc has, and you get points for doing so, and you know, so on and so forth. See, and you see, because I UAV'd them, I then get the tag assist. Oh, he's coming after me, he wants a bit of my body. Yeah, you can duck behind walls, stuff like that. Typical Splinter Cell stuff, but you see me, I'm dead. Come on, I'm scared. Oh, you tease me! Tease me, baby! Till I lose control. And, you know, like, as you can see, in full motion there, the sheer skill that the spy has, like, I've totally managed to avoid him. Like, he can't get anywhere near me now. Like, he's looking through that vent because he knows that I can go through there if I wanted to. But I'm basically just right here. You know, if I could open that door, I would chop his face off. But, you know, I can't, because there's a wall in the way. Now that, oh shit, I can hear a drone. So as you just heard then, and you see on the screen the drone hunter, the mercs have the ability, they can have an ability to send out a drone, which is like a little flying grenade, basically. It scouts, and it explodes on button press. And it is very handy to have, but people got wise to it too quick, and people started having the anti-drone devices, which was a bit of a pain in the ass at first. But you know, the meta game sort of shifts, like people start using different, less obvious things, like the adrenaline for the merc will make you see better, you know. And go on, get him. Yeah, it's going well. So yeah. Spies versus Mercs is amazing. Like, you know, like I say, each character player has like a, here we go, go on. Sick! And that's why I love the game. Like, the Mercs can't do the zip line. The Mercs can't do the death from above, but I can. And then after this round's over in 1 minute and 45 seconds, I'll then be the Merc against the Spies, and you'll see just how different the game feels. And I'm thinking, because I'm playing on PC, that the when you're a merc, it's best to play with a gamepad, because I seem to die a lot more frequently as a merc. And people seem to be shooting me when they're mercs, like real quick and fast aiming, whereas I'm on a gamepad at the moment because, you know, comfort. I like to sit back in my chair and play. But what I'm doing here is like a classic distraction technique where I'm trying to like just basically pull him away from the hacker by just knobbing around. Yes. He's won it. Yes, that shouldn't have worked, but it did. Loving it. Yes, go on. This is going really well. And the idea with Spies vs. Mercs is just to remember that you're not as shit as what you think you are. Like, it's too easy just to go, oh, I'm rubbish. And I'll admit, like, the first sort of, like, 5 to 10 hours that I played of this game, it was me just fumbling around with the controls. Oh, it's just A left now, is it? Yeah. Ass. And as you can see, like, I'm level 40 at the moment. Doing alright, you know. Sort of good couple of hours, which is good for a spy. You mainly get most of your points as mercs. Right, now we're going to be a merc. And we'll see how the game feels completely different, yet not, because it's in the same, you know, it's in the same world, it's in the same, but it feels completely different, like the levels, because you're in a different perspective, literally feels completely like unnatural. It's really weird to explain, but like when you're a merc, you don't, doesn't feel the same. Like you see corners that you can only see as a spy, and then when you're a merc like this, look how closed it feels. It feels, you know, so closed off. It feels so tunnel vision, like, oh man, you can't see behind you, so you're constantly like second guessing yourself, playing like proxy mines behind you, smoke grenades in the corners where you can't really reach, i.e. here, stuff like that, to smoke them out. This guy there, ah, oh, see, he's got the anti-drone system, the anti-gadget system, which basically negated my smoke grenade, and again, so there's one definitely up there. Oh, he's just throwing a flashbang. Shit, run away. Oh, don't do it, mate. He's going to get shot down. Oh, shit, he's throwing a sticky cam. And all the noises that this game makes, more specifically as a merc, is there to help you survive. You'll get used to it, like these noises that trigger off and happen, and you go, oh, right, so I just heard a bloop, bloop, bloop. That means the sticky camera's gone down. Oh, and I've just been jacked. And like, I couldn't even see where he was, and that's the beauty of being a spy. And again, like, you know, the beauty of being a merc. Like, if I could have seen him, the chances of him getting away would have been very minimal, but, you know, I've got the limited field of vision in first person. When you're dead, you can skip around between cameras, which is very handy. Some of that, you bastard. So as a merc, I've got adrenaline. Sometimes I have the drone, sometimes I don't. It all depends on how the meta game feels. And I know I sound like a pompous twat saying that, but it is true. Like, people gravitate towards one type of thing, and then the anti thing for that comes out, and then the anti thing comes out for the new thing, and people are constantly shifting what they play with and how it works. But the adrenaline, basically, as you saw then, it illuminates the room, it makes me reload quicker. It makes the field of view better, sort of like fisheye lens. As you can see, like, it'll pull it back so I'll get to see more of the room, like whoop. And yeah, it really helps. Especially when it's sunny. I'm playing when it's sunny and I'm finding that, oh, I just saw one up there. Who is that? See if I can get a headshot. Oh shit, it's just throwing something at me, run away! Now we're too, the classic distraction technique here, we're too busy focusing on one guy where we shouldn't be. Ah, oh, he's got me. Yep. We should be going to the hacker zone. It's too easy to just to get distracted from the zone that's being hacked. And you know, let them have it. So as you see at the top there, he's hacking at 45%. When it gets to 100, obviously, they get the point. Now, when it comes to a draw situation where there's where they've hacked two and we've hacked two, it'll come down to the percentage of, you know, that last final third terminal being hacked. It doesn't tell you until the end, so it's all quite tense if it's 2-0 and you're like, oh, shit. Just saw him over there. You go smoking him out. Got him. And again, like, it's all to do with just split-second decisions like that. Like, okay, I've seen him in a far corner of a room. How do I get him out of there? Smoke grenade. Okay, cool. This adrenaline also regenerates my health real quick, which is nice. He's there. Oh, shit. Here we go again. I've played a bit of co-op with Darren Foreman and James Carter, but not enough to even give any thought, you know, make meaningful opinion on it. It's good, like, don't get me wrong, but it's not why I play this game. I play this game for this, and, you know, if this was just a bog standard multiplayer mode, I wouldn't be playing it at all, let alone to like level 40 odd. Oh, classic. Yeah, the problem I'm having now is that I think I'm too good when I'm not. And the same with all multiplayer games. The reason why I stop is because I get frustrated because I'm not as good as I used to be. And, you know, the maps are getting quite boring now. Like, I've played about 70 matches of this, and, you know, when there's only like 6 maps, you know. And then some of the maps aren't very good, like Lebanese Hospital isn't very good, it's too narrow. I just think it's just a bit of a, you know, it grates on you after a while, but, you know, I haven't got much else going on, so fuck it. Let's just play it. Gutted. I've had some funny bugs in this game where one guy kept falling over even though he was running. Like, the animation of him dying kept repeating, but he was running around. That led to some humorous. Oh, there he is there. Wicked. And so, like, the idea is when you play as a merc is to remember where you would hide as a spy and sort of go there. But, like I say, like, the level feels, like, you know, completely different. It feels. Doesn't feel the same, it feels unnatural. All terminals are reading vulnerable. Keep it safe. Oh man, the predator flipping suit freaks the shit out of me. Whoa, what happened there? Ah, okay, so when I have a proximity mine in my hand, you can zap them with the stun crossbow. To then, you know, trigger the mine off in his hands. It rarely happens, but when it does, it is magic. So you want to be careful because this is where they spawn. They'll take you for a ride. Oh, here we go. But again, distraction. We're being distracted away from the terminal. I don't remember laying a mine. How nice. Ah, he's right behind us. That's something I can really never do. Because it always feels like if I was that spy, I would have got spotted, and, you know, I don't know. It feels really weird. Like, you have to be really confident as both to kill. If you're not confident, then you're just gonna die. Like, you can't hesitate at all. You have to make split second decisions and do your thing. Like, you know, when do I throw a proxy down? When I've got adrenaline on, because he throws it quicker. So on and so forth. So as you can see, it feels like Rainbow Six, like, especially that. Like, that just reminds me of Rainbow Six big time. Oh, he was right up me there. There he is. No, it's not the hacker, but still. There is another one. No, it's not the hacker, but. There we go, there's no one. Got him. And, you know, I saw those because I played the game so much. I think I'm approaching 30 odd hours now, 35 hours in multiplayer, and I'm not great, but I can still see, like, the nuances and, like, the character movement and stuff like that. Like, it's quite hard to explain. But yeah. We've got another 2 minutes of this. And then I'll be bouncing. And I don't know if I'll play this game again. after this. I'm getting a bit frustrated, like I say. I'm getting a bit taking it too seriously. But I want to hit the level cap. Like, I feel like I should see a multiplayer game through to the end, if you know what I mean. If there is an end to multiplayer. I don't know. Usually I get bored, like, or frustrated. I think here it's a bit of both. But that's not to say it's not worth playing. Like, this is flipping brilliant. I'm loving this. But I don't know. I just saw one there. Go, drone, go! Woo! So you can hear him up there, so you sort of want to pay attention to the edges. Yeah, there we go. Oh, he stunned me. I knew he was coming. It's typical. You know, as the merc, if you find yourself getting flashed too much, you can then choose the anti-flash. Like, you know, I've got a suit specifically for anti-flash. And, you know, so on and so forth. You can flip between styles of play. But usually you find the two or three things that click with you. And you stick with them. Like, for me, the proxy and the gas seems to work brilliantly. Oh, shit, here we go. So I've dropped the mine. Will he die? No. And that's another thing that makes me a bit frustrated with this game, is that you spawn in the level. Like, you spawn in the level. Just that alone is frustrating. Like, you spawn next to a spy. You're like, no, I think the spawn system needs to be better. Like, you need to be positioned further away from the players. Because, like, to wait 15 seconds. Oh, God. And then die straight away because the game spawned me next to the spy. It's a bit shit, I'm not gonna lie. It's a bit frustrating. Yeah, got him. 98% as well. Suck on that. Just too late to save his life. So, like, when someone's being accosted like that, you know, ready for the next slicing, you can stop them by killing them first. So they're hacking the terminal when the time's run out, which means they get time extend until either they hack the terminal or they the flipping hell's going on there. You know, either they hack the terminal or the hacker dies, which just happened then. So they got 90 seconds to reset the hack. On B. If they don't, the time runs out, and we win. I mean, we've won either way because it's 2-0, and they can't hack two terminals. Get my health back, thank you. Well, there we go. That's spies versus mercs for you. Spy in his little hidey hole there. There we go. So yeah, Spies vs. Mercs is brilliant. It just needs a bit more refinement. It needs a few more maps or not modes, but it just needs a bit more variety in it needs a bit more variety in the customization, because people are getting used to all the gadgets now, and it's just a bit like, yeah, okay, so he's got this, and this is how you anti that, and I don't know. It just needs a little bit more oomph. It's good. Don't get me wrong, it's really good. And like I say, I wouldn't have played it for. Let's have a look. Can I check out the stats? Yeah, I wouldn't have played it for how many matches I have. Like, it is well worth playing, but it comes to a point where you just think, okay, seen it all before, and I'm only playing it because I've got nothing else going on. Like, you know, there's nothing else in my life. GTA's next week, GTA 5, so you sort of know when this has been recorded, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, and so, like, you know, I'm just playing it because why not just play. But it's come to the point now where I think I need to put it to bed. But let's have a little look around here. ShadowNet, which is the handy name for the stats. So Spies vs. Mercs stats. I've won 31. I've lost 32. So the game is pretty balanced, you see, as you can see. Like, you know, it's pretty even. It's sort of, I've died more than I've killed, but not by much. And I've won less than I've lost. Does that make any sense? Yeah. So yeah, and the game is like, I don't know, it depends. Like, the games can last up to half an hour, or they can be like quite quick, like that one. So yeah, that's 60. I'd say I've played about 30 hours. Yeah, it's good. Okay, yeah. So that's been Spy vs. Mercs. This is Sam Fisher. Look at him, what a freak. and it just doesn't look the same. But it obviously doesn't look the same. It doesn't even resemble what it used to look like, which is a bit of a shame in my eyes. But you know, changes happen. We have to get over these things. And now we're just going to wander around this airplane. Do 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 do. Well, can I open the door? Ooh. See, this is how much I haven't played the single player. I didn't actually know this was all in here. Wicked, there's a little helicopter in. Can I get in it? No. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you later.